Hello Ice and Fire Nerds, this is Chris and welcome back to another Game of Thrones Season 7 Theory video, and today let's talk about Varys. What the hell is he doing in our story? Why is he important? And more importantly, what the hell did he hear in those damn flames?
Dracarys.
Alright, so let's jump right in. I've always thought Varys was a very, very interesting character. He's one of the most powerful characters in our story because, of course, he is the Master of Whispers. Varys is a very mysterious character. We've always wondered what his importance is. And, of course, they introduced us to the idea of his past and how he became who he is today in our story because he got his junk cut off.
Root and stem.
But the point being here that we knew early on he was a eunuch. We really didn't know why. But as he got to know Tyrion and seemed to want to tell him this story about what happened to him. So as a matter of fact, let's let Varys tell the story himself.
He gave me a potion that made me powerless to move or speak, yet did nothing to dull my senses. With a hooked blade, he sliced me, root and stem, chanting all the while. He burned my parts, the brazier. The flames turned blue, and I heard a voice answer his call.
So we saw in this clip in a previous season that he had told Tyrion his story about why he was cut, but more importantly, when he got his junk cut off,
root and stem,
that he had heard something in those flames that the sorcerer that he got revenge on tossed his parts into the flames, they turned blue, he was chanting something, and Varys is not sure what he heard, but he did hear something reply in the flames. So if this wouldn't have happened to Varys, we probably wouldn't know who the hell he is. We probably would have never heard his name. And I definitely believe that he wouldn't be important to our story at all. But I think now that Varys is actually indirectly very, very important to our end game. So let's talk about that for a second and talk about what changed in his life when he got his shit cut off.
Root and stem.
So first of all, we know by his story, what he told to Tyrion, that it did change his life in a big, big way. He realized that the contents of a man's letters were more important than the contents of his purse. He learned that information was power. He became an information broker. And of course, later on down the road, this led to him coming across the Narrow Sea to Westeros from Essos and becoming very powerful in the sense that he was the Master of Whispers for a couple kings. And I firmly believe that he would have never gotten to that point in his life if it wasn't for what happened with the sorcerer. So then, of course, he comes to power as the Master of Whispers. And later on, he hooks up with Illyrio and they start this little thing about the target and restoration. So of course, with him becoming very powerful in the information business, he comes over to Westeros, he ends up on the small council, and from there, of course, he can start working his magic and manipulating events in order to actually kick off this Targaryen restoration. Now, of course, with him supporting Dany, this is a very big deal because without his help, Dany may not even be alive to actually come to Westeros and take back what she believes is rightfully hers, being the Iron Throne. Now, in the books, this is slightly different. He supports Aegon, and Aegon may be a Targaryen, he may be a Blackfyre, but basically it's still the same backstory. It's still the same thing. Varys is starting to manipulate events in order to institute a Targaryen restoration because I think he actually believes he's doing the best thing for the realm. So with him actually getting in bed with Illyrio and supporting this, he actually is protecting Dany. Now, I don't believe that Robert had hired knives chasing Dany and Viserys down their entire lives necessarily. I believe that was a little embellishment on Viserys' part. There's probably some truth to that, but as we saw in season one of Game of Thrones, there were attempts on her life, and of course, Varys is the one who actually saved her life. Of course, Robert wanted her dead, and Varys never actually sent the orders to have her killed, but he knew there was going to be an attempt, and of course, he sent the pardon to Jorah, letting him know that the wine merchant was going to make an attempt on her life, and therefore, Varys was responsible for saving Dany's life. So, what am I saying here? Indirectly, Varys caused the return of dragons. And it's also a little mysterious that Valyrio, his very partner, is the one that gave Dany those dragon eggs in the first place at her wedding feast with Khal Drogo. That's a separate video entirely as far as Valyrio and his plans and what he thinks those dragon eggs were going to do. But the point being here is that Varys indirectly changed Dany's life and therefore dragons came back to the world. And of course, being in support of a Targaryen restoration, he started to recruit people to his cause, people like Tyrion Lannister. He truly believes that Tyrion Lannister has a great mind and thought that Tyrion would be the best person to serve Dany and to counsel her to give her the best chance of taking back the Iron Throne. So therefore, through his workings, because of his past, because of the experience he had with the Red Priest, Dany is alive and well. Dragons come back to the world, and now she is on her way to Westeros, although she doesn't know yet she's about to be thrown in a much, much bigger war. So basically, in a nutshell, what I'm saying here is this. I believe that his life was changed forever because he got his junk cut off.
Root and stem.
He knows his life was changed forever, and as a matter of fact, in Season 6, Kinvara kind of gives us the answer.
Terrible things happen for a reason. Take what happened to you, Lord Varys, when you were a child. If not for your mutilation at the hand of a second-rate sorcerer, you wouldn't be here.
So basically, she's telling us what's actually going on here, that everything happens for a reason. Now, I do not think there are religions in this story, but in her religion, she believes that Dany is the prince that was promised, whereas Melisandre believes it's Jon. So what the hell did he hear in the flames, and who the hell said it? So basically, if you think about his past, and you think about how his life changed, and what he's done, and what he's accomplished, and how much he is of a player to the endgame of our story, as far as Dany and dragons, and Targaryen restoration, and all that good stuff, he is indirectly going to be responsible for helping to save the world. So therefore, I think the voice in the flames was simply Bloodraven. I think that all these other religions, R'hllor, the Red God, all these other major religions, basically spawned off these pagan-style religions, just like in the real world, from the old gods or the green seers and the children of the forest. So I think it's Bloodraven who's actually speaking to people through flames, including Melisandre, because he can send visions to people. And this is supported a bit in the books as well. There is a chapter in A Dance with Dragons where Melisandre has a chapter where she actually sees Bloodraven and Bran in the flames, where she sees a thousand eyes and a boy with a wolf's head who leans back and howls. Now, of course, in her perspective, they look like the enemy, servants of the Great Other, because she sees these visions through the lens of her own religion. But I still think it's Bloodraven manipulating events both on this side of the world in Westeros and in Essos, as far as Dany and Jon bringing them together to actually save the damn world, because Bloodraven knows what's going on in the future. He knows what's coming. He's known this for a long, long time. I believe he was likely responsible for the Mad King, at least in part, going mad, and in turn, Aerys the Second Targaryen likely went mad, although he didn't need much help due to the inbreeding. So if I think it's Bloodraven who said something to Varys in the flames to change his life and to help him manipulate events to get Dany to Westeros with dragons, what do I think he actually said? Well, I think it's pretty simple. I think K'nvar kind of hinted to that in season 6.
Helping the Lord's chosen bring his light into the world. Knowledge has made you powerful. Do you remember what you heard that night? When the sorcerer tossed your parts in the fire, you heard a voice call out from the flames. Do you remember? Should I tell you what the voice said? Should I tell you the name of the one who spoke?
And I think the voice in the flames simply said Daenerys Targaryen, or Daenerys Stormborn, something to that effect. And of course, this was many, many years before Dany would be born. So that's another reason I believe it's actually Bloodraven, because he, of course, would have seen the future and knew Dany was going to be born in the first place in order to change Varys' life, have him become an information broker, essentially, come to power and actually protect her, and therefore causing dragons to be born again into this world and be indirectly responsible for her coming across to Westeros, although she doesn't know it yet, but she's going to be a big part of saving the damn world. So anyway, guys, that's my basic take on it. I believe this was Bloodraven manipulating events. I believe he saw the opportunity with this Red Priest who got a hold of Varys, who cut his junk off,
root and stem,
threw it in the fire. He took the opportunity to whisper to Varys through the flames, Daenerys Targaryen. Now, Varys doesn't know exactly what he heard, but it did change his life. Maybe subconsciously he knows. He supports a Targaryen restoration with a guy who actually gives Dany dragon eggs later down the road and indirectly causes dragons to come back to the world and causes Dany to come over to Westeros seeking what she believes is hers in the Iron Throne. And now, of course, when she gets there, she'll find out about the big war to come and the true threat to Westeros. So all in all, I think this is Bloodraven manipulating events, just like he did with Jon Snow. I believe he often warged Lord Commander Mormont's Raven to say certain things to kind of set Jon up to become Lord Commander. So I think he was also doing the same thing across the Narrow Sea with Dany to bring these two together and save the damn world. Let me know what you think in the comments below. As usual, thank you for all the support, especially to you guys on Patreon. And of course, a huge shout out to my executive Patreon Smokestream producers, Paul Griffin, Ball Guy 10, Lala Gig, Kissa Powell, Marylin Bentley, Marc Joseph, aka The Snow in Winterfell, Kissa Powell, JoAnna, Sean Hayes, and Linda Stanfield. Thank you guys so much. I really, really appreciate the support. And if you dig what I do here, please give me a like and a share. Be sure to subscribe to get everything, and be sure to click that notification bell so you're notified when I drop a new video. Thanks again, you guys. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you
and so next time. We spoke, and so we spoke, that Lord of Castan. Now the rains we pour is hard.